right on target. This company makes military parachutes. Each one has a 30-foot wingspan and carries up to 440 pounds. Making the chute's canopy starts with a rugged woven nylon fabric with nylon ribbing. This light table lets a worker detect any flaws in the fabric. The alignment between the ribbing must be consistent, spaced no more than 1.5 inches apart. They test the strength of the fabric by pulling the material until it rips. To pass, the fabric must withstand a minimum of 44 pounds of pulling force. A laser cuts out the parachute parts, 30 to 100 of them, depending on the model. A vacuum system stabilizes the fabric by sucking it to the table during cutting. The fabric is usually silver-colored to blend in against the daytime sky. A seamstress now sews on nylon tape to attach the parts and reinforce the seams. Some panels have holes about the size of a dinner plate to funnel air between the two layers of the canopy and keep it rigid during flight. Once they finish sewing, workers meticulously inspect the stitching. Every inch of stitching must have between 7 and 10 stitches. If the stitching is too close or too far apart, the fabric could rip. And that's the last thing you want when your chute is descending at a rate of up to 13 feet per second. So they mark any problem spots with a red ribbon and re-sew them. Here, a worker sews nylon tape to reinforce an area called a flare, which is a triangular patch of nylon reinforced to 14.5 feet per line and cuts it on an angle to reduce fraying. Workers later sew the ends into loops so they can attach each one to the loop on the flares. A worker makes a lark's head knot in each line and ties it to a flare. This type of knot is easy to undo if a line needs replacing. Connecting the 60 lines to the canopy's 60 flares takes about 2 hours. Only after all these knots are secure can they pack the chute into the backpack and ship it to the customer. The nylon backpack has two identical parachutes, the main chute and a reserve. This worker is sewing the panels that will encase the reserve chute. Extra stitching reinforces the strap connecting the steel buckle, which fastens an extra pack for up to 100 pounds. It's critical to strictly follow the company's instructions when packing the chute. You roll the ends, then fold the rest into layers. Before each jump, you have to untangle the lines and check for any tears from the previous jump. Then you insert the lines and canopy into the pack. You pull on this red nylon handle to deploy the main chute. The yellow handle is for the reserve chute. There are straps over the shoulders, chest, belly, and legs, and three buckles attach the harness to the jumper.